Okay, now we are discussing the characteristics of VC generator. There are basically three kinds of characteristics from a DC generator. One is open circuit characteristics or magnetization characteristics. Second is internal characteristics, and third one is external characteristics. Okay. First one is representing the open circuit characteristics or magnetization curve or characteristics. This curve is drawn between the generated EMF and field current only. This is drawn between the generated EMF inside the armature and the field current that is supplied to the field winding. Now, another is internal characteristics. If we are considering armature reaction, if we are considering armature reaction in the picture, then we get a different kind of characteristics, that is called as internal characteristics. So okay, so this is the effect of armature reaction. As you know that due to the armature reaction, there are two effects. One is demagnetizing effect, another is cross magnetizing effect. Due to cross magnetizing effect, sparking occurs at the terminal or at brushes. But due to demagnetizing effect, the magnitude of magnetic flux reduces, and due to that part, the EMF generated is reduced. Okay, this is the part, and this is the voltage in volt. Okay, this characteristic is drawn between EMF. And third one is the external characteristic. That is taking the armature drop into the picture. That is given as IAR drop. Okay. And so this is called as external characteristic. That is between the terminal voltage and load current, means the terminal voltage, and IL is the load current. Okay, that means if we are not considering any kind of losses, then system will show the magnetization curve or open circuit characteristic. And if we are taking armature reaction into the picture, then we get another characteristic, that is known as internal characteristics, that is drawn between the E and IE. Okay, where E is the EMF induced in the armature, and IE is the current flowing through the armature. Okay, and third one is external characteristic. That is, as we are considering the armature voltage drop, if we are considering armature voltage drop, that is IEI drop. Then we will get another characteristic that is called as external characteristic, that is drawn between the terminal voltage V and the load current IL. Okay. Now we will define another terms for that characteristic. Critical resistance. Critical resistance is the resistance which is introduced in the field winding circuit, so that after that value of the field winding resistance, generators won't be able to develop any kind of EMF. That value of critical resistance, that value of resistance is called as critical resistance, and it is represented by RC. And it can, how it can determine? To determine that kind of the value of critical resistance, what we have to do? First, we have to draw the OCC. OCC, okay? That is a curve between the generated EMF and the field current. Okay? So I am drawing that. This is a OCC, that means, or it is called as magnetization curve. This is OCC or magnetization curve. OCC means open circuit changing field current. Okay? And as you know that E equals to N and phi, E is proportional to, if N constant, then N is E proportional to phi, or E is proportional to IF, since phi is proportional to IF. Okay? So, what we are observing, as we are increasing the IF, field current, the value of generated EMF is increased, but after a certain level, saturation occurs, and after that, how much we are increasing the value of field current, the generated voltage will not increase. Okay, it's not in ampere, it is in volt. Okay, so this is the OCC. For that, we will take the different values of field current and we will check the generated EMF. Now, what's our object? To determine the critical resistance. So, what we have to do? We have to draw a tangent to the OCC. Okay? And now, once tangent is drawn, now determine the coordinates at any point on the line. Determine coordinates at any point on the line, or determine the slope of this line. The slope of tangent line. The slope of that tangent line will give the value of critical resistance, because as we are increasing the value of resistance, once condition, after this condition, resistance value will be like this, and then it is not touching the OCC, means now generator will fail to develop any kind of voltage. Here, for example, this is X1, this is y1. Then what are the coordinates? X1, y1. Then easily we can determine its slope. And the slope of the tangent line will give the value of critical distance. Even for any value of resistance, we can determine the generated voltage. For example, for RSH equal to 100, what should be the generated EMF wave equivalent? Then what we will do? We will take the combination, because when we are talking about the slope, means that is the, you know, the ratio of vertical value to the horizontal value. Okay, so we got R equals to voltage upon current or E upon IF. So we will take the combination of voltage E and IF so that its value should be equal to 100. So for example, if I am taking 200 volt and 2 ampere current, then it will give the value of 100 ohm. Okay, so for example, I am taking this is the value of 2 ampere here, and this is the value of for 2 ampere. This is 200 volt. So now we will draw a line, straight line, that is passing through this one. So the value field resistance is here 100 ohm, and for that value the voltage would be 200. Where this line is cutting or intersecting the OCC, at that moment the vertical axis will show the value that is going to develop at the OCC for the field. Okay, next is critical speed. Next is critical speed. Critical speed is denoted by NC. Critical speed is a speed at which any value field resistance act as critical resistance. So it is the, again I am repeating, it is the speed at which any value field resistance act as critical resistance. So next object is how to determine next object is how to determine another OCC at different speed from the given OCC. That means now for the speed m1 we are having this OCC, and we are having different values for field current and okay. So if it is even, IF is fixed, as we know that for even is proportional to n1, if IF is constant, let IF is change in flux is as first one. Then E1 is proportional to N1 and E2 is proportional to N2. Therefore, what we can do? Now go for E2 upon E1 equals to N2 upon N1 and E2 equals to E1 into N2 upon N1. Since this ratio is known, this value is also known for a particular value of fuel gun, then we can easily determine the value of E2 for IL. Now calculate E2 for so by using this relation, E2 is known for different values of IF. For IF1 we are having even value because this part is constant, so another OCC can be drawn from this one. Okay, another term is voltage regulation. As we know that if generated at no load, the generated voltage or terminal voltage at a terminal end would be higher, and as we are connecting the load to the armature of generator, definitely armature reaction takes place as well as the armature drop takes place. Due to those losses, definitely as the load is increasing, the terminal voltage goes decreasing, so that the change in voltage from no load to full load, the change in terminal voltage from no load to full load is known as voltage regulation, and it is expressed in terms of percentage. So it is mathematically mentioned as this is the expression of voltage regulation. Okay, and in the case of DC motor, we will talk about the speed regulation. This is for generator or motor, we talk about the speed regulation. As we know that the output of motor is mechanical, so if the motor is at no load, definitely its rotating speed will be higher, and as the mechanical load increases over it, definitely the speed will decrease. So that in the case of generator, we are having electrical loading, so voltage regulation is there, but in the case of motor there is mechanical loading, so speed changes. So the change in speed from no load to full load is known as speed regulation. It is also expressed in the percentage. So speed that is ओके This is the characteristic for compound generator, that is cumulative compound as well as differentially compound. So we are having four kind of characteristics. Three belongs to cumulative compound and one belongs to differential compound. For cumulative compound we are having over compound, flat compound and under compound. Okay. So we talk about the flat compound first of all. If the series field excitation is adjusted such that the terminal voltage at no load and terminal voltage at full load is equal, then that kind of generator is called as flat compound generator. Means how the series field excitation is so adjusted that the terminal voltage at no load and the terminal voltage at full load are equal. That kind of generator is called as flat compound or flat compound DC generator. If the series field winding predominates the shunt field winding, then what will happen? As the load increases, definitely the terminal voltage will increase. If any kind of generator shows that kind of characteristics, that means as the load increases, the terminal voltage also increases. Then that kind of generator is called as over compound generator. Third one is under compound generator. In this kind of generator, series field winding dominates the, shunt field winding dominates the series field winding, so that as the load increases, the terminal voltage goes decreasing. That kind of generator is called as under compound generator. And when you talk about the differential compound generator, then that means there is always the difference of series field winding and shunt field winding, so its voltage will always go down, so its characteristics will be shown as the downward direction. We are going to discuss about the losses and efficiency. In generator and motor both. Okay, so So in a easier way, we can classify the losses as mechanical losses and electrical losses. Mechanical losses consisting of frictional losses as well as windage losses. Frictional losses means to reduce when the shaft rotates, there would be friction in the machine. But to reduce that friction, we are using bearings. So we can control at some level the friction losses by using bearings. Another is windage losses. As you know that generator doesn't work in the vacuum condition, definitely there would be wind. So when the armature winding is rotating, definitely it will come in contact with the wind as well as air. So to overcome that pressure, some losses will occur. Those are known as windage losses. Now talk about the electrical losses. So in the electric losses, we can classify into two categories. One is constant losses, another is variable losses. So constant losses means the losses, those are fixed and those will happen every time. The first one is iron losses. Iron losses is consisting of hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. Hysteresis loss is due to the material we are using in the during the construction of any machine. So that can be controlled by using a better material. And eddy current losses occurs in the metal piece. So to reduce the eddy current losses, we go for the laminated sheets, so that we can control the eddy current losses. But these losses will occur every time, even at the no load condition. So these losses are fixed or constant losses. Similarly, if we are going for the shunt field DC generator, then definitely whether the generator is connected to the load or not, a particular amount of current will be taken by the shunt field winding. So there would be always I square R losses, that is represented by I square R SH, will happen always. Now talking about the variable losses. So armature losses, or we can say the losses happened in the armature winding are known as armature losses, as well as series field winding losses. If there is a compound generator or there is only series generator, then in that condition definitely these two losses will occur and those will change with the changing load. And these are given as I square RA, this is I square SE. Okay. Condition of maximum efficiency. That means when any generator will give maximum efficiency. So when, since we are having two kind of losses, one is constant losses, another is the variable losses. Means constant losses are fixed, means only variable losses can be changed. So the condition is that when variable losses equals the constant losses, in that condition definitely the machine will give the maximum efficiency. Okay. Now to understand the various kind of losses occurring in the generator as well as motor, we can use the blocks. When the mechanical power is inputted to the armature of any DC generator, then what will happen? Mechanical losses. Okay. Means there is nothing is developing there. There is no magnetic field is there. Then in the first step, what will happen? Mechanical losses will occur. Then, if armature starts generating voltage, then what will come into the picture? Iron losses. Okay. Then, I square R losses will come into the picture. Or here we can say again fixed losses. In the easy way we can say fixed losses will occur there. And in the third part, I square R losses will occur. This is called the generator. Okay. When you talk about the motor, the diagram will be reversed. Okay, first we are giving the input voltage V, then definitely losses, these losses will occur and fixed losses will occur. And at the last, mechanical losses will occur at the shaft of the motor, or at the shaft of the motor, mechanical losses will occur. So if we go in the reverse direction, definitely the motoring action will come into the picture, and if we are going moving from left to right, the generator action will take place. Okay, this is all about the losses of the losses happening in the generator as well as in the case of motor.